Let's set up Redux in our universal React web application. Currently, we have React Router set up on the server as well as a client. So now let's add Redux, a library that helps manage your state. Go to your terminal and install Redux and react-redux. The difference between the two is that Redux creates a store, whereas react-redux provides React bindings to the store. Now let's add Redux on the server side. Open route/index.jsx. Import Redux from Redux and provider from react-redux. We'll create a very basic reducer that simply returns a state that is given. And then let's create our Redux store. The first parameter is the reducer function, and the second parameter is the optional initial state. Let's rename the variable just to keep things semantic. Since the state will be handled by Redux, we no longer need to merge our custom props with the router's render props and create element. So let's remove it. Accordingly, provider will be the root component, so wrap router context inside of it. And let's not forget to pass a store to provider. Save the file, open client.js. We'll be doing the same thing here. Paste the same dependencies and reducer, but when you create the store, pass in window.props as the initial state. Once again, we wrap routes inside a provider. And don't forget to surround routes with curly braces because it's a React element, not text. We also need to make React available because the JSX syntax transpiles down to react.createElement. Save the file, open webpack.config.js. Here, I'm making an adjustment to my loader so that both JS and JSX files will be transpiled by Babel. The reason, of course, is due to the recent additions to client.js. Save the config and go to the window that's running Webpack. You'll notice the red output because Webpack wasn't able to compile the JSX inside of client.js. Press Ctrl+C to stop it from running, and then restart Webpack. Nice, no errors or warnings. Go back to your text editor and open route/routes.jsx. Delete createElement from router here as well. Save the file, open view/layout.jsx. Here we'll need to import connect from react-redux. Then instead of directly exporting our component, we'll assign it to a variable. Something you may not be aware of is that the variable name is the component's default display name. So we can remove the redundant property. Now let's connect our component to the provider store. We'll be using the connect method. The first parameter is the function that maps the state of the provider store to the props of your component. Here, let's ensure our custom props are still mapped to the key custom. You may be wondering why I assigned the return value of connect to the variable wrapper. That's because connect is a higher order component, which means that you'll need to wrap your component inside of the return function. As a result, this creates a new component. For those who are curious about how connect works, it's using React context under the hood in order to get access to provider. And let's not forget to export the component. Save the file and switch to your browser. Refresh the page and you'll see that everything's still working. If you open React DevTools, you'll see provider as the root component. You also see connect with the store state of the initial data passed down from the server. And in layout, you'll notice that your custom prop has not changed. Going forward, you can set up actions and reducers. And that's all it takes to set up Redux for universal rendering.